Hello YouTubers, today we will repair a JBL soundbar with the model number Cinema SB350. It has several inputs like auxiliary in, Bluetooth and HDMI RLC, means audio return channel. And the subwoofer you see here is wirelessly connected to the soundbar. My brother-in-law gave me this thing because it's faulty. The problem with it is, there is no sound from the soundbar but just from the subwoofer. Let's dive into troubleshooting and repair it. Let's disassemble the thing. First of all, we need to remove the feet. And now try to get with some plastic tools and remove the cover. So now if the cover is removed, we need to find some screws. There are some knobs, there are Phillips screws behind. So after nearly 1000 screws, I got the mainboard out. And look what I see here. There is an 8-pin IC which is completely burnt. Here comes the power from the power supply, and I assume that this is a kind of a MOSFET, probably a P-channel type. It's controlled by this small signal transistor and goes here for four wires to the bottom side and supplies the two output stages for the speakers. Let's desolder this IC, clean this area, and after that I will look in the datasheet of this output stage and check if there is a short circuit, because this damage is usually happens when the if the IC which is supplied has a short circuit. This is isopropanol, and I will try to clean it up. So luckily I found the service manual of the soundbar, and in the content section we see that there are block diagrams, wiring diagrams and also schematics. First let's jump into the block diagram of the soundbar. And this is not the soundbar, this is the subwoofer with one speaker. Here's the soundbar. Here's the mains power supply. It provides around 19 volt and maximum current of 3 amps. And this is the direct supply for the amplifier. Now we need to find the schematic for that. And here it is. Here we have our input. Some filtering. Small signal transistor, the P-channel MOSFET, and this is the MOSFET is for the standby function. So if on the base of the small signal transistor are 0 volts, then the MOSFET is opened and gate source voltage is 0 volts, and there is no current flow to the amplifier. If the standby goes too high, I assume some 5 volts, the small signal transistor gets conducted and the gate voltage will be charged up by this voltage divider. So 10 by 10 or 19 volt would mean gate source would be minus around 9.5 volt. And the amplifier will be supplied by the 19 volts. So later we will measure all the voltages, and I assume that the schematic would fit, but maybe not the values, because sometimes there are many hardware revisions and they change values, maybe also components. Now let's go to the amplifier itself. Here you see the damaged P-type channel MOSFET. To replace this, I need basically to look on the most important data, which is maximum gate source voltage, maximum drain source voltage, RDS on, and the replacement part should not be worse than this. I will probably buy a better one to be sure that it will last longer than this one before. Here we see our two ICs, which are supplied by the power supply, at least after the MOSFET. And we need to figure out how to check the output stage. Let's jump into the datasheet. Here I already prepared the datasheet for the amplifier. We need the functional block diagram. And you see here the four push-pull stages. And they are all supplied by the PVCC, which is the switched 19 volt power supply. And to simply check the push-pull stages, we need to measure with our multimeter the diodes, the body diodes of the push-pull stages, and if we will not see a short circuit but the voltage drop of a diode, then we can clearly say that at least the power stage is not in short circuit. Please notice on the naming of the output signals, there is output positive right and output negative right. This is simply the two connections of the speaker. So this should be the right speaker, and here we see the left speaker. Here is the board with the amplifier stages, and now we want to check the body diodes of the push-pull stages. Here you see the 19 volt comes from pin 32 and 31, the two upper one, and 17, 18 and 19, same potential. So the cathode is on PVCC and the output stage. First diode is okay. This diode is okay. This is okay. This is okay. Now we need to change the polarity, and let's grab the ground from somewhere on the top. I take this one to check that it's really a ground. I go here and I see on the schematic pin 22 is also ground. 17, 18, 19, 20. So this connection is ground, and let's check the other diodes. This is okay, this is okay, this is okay, also okay. Let's check the other one. Okay, Okay. And from the top. Okay. So it seems that the output stages are not shorted. The next thing I want to try is to supply the output stage with 19 volt and look at the current consumption. What you need is a power supply with a current limit. I set my current limit to 0.5 amp. Our ground is here. And here we have the positive connection. So it seems we don't have a short. As a quick check, we could bridge the drain and source of the MOSFET, like the connections where the MOSFET was, and connect everything back to the soundbar and try it out. If this will work, then I need to order a replacement for this MOSFET, solder it in, repair the connections, and should be repaired. The soldering bridge looks like this. So basically I bridge the MOSFET. There's no standby function anymore, at least for the output stage. To be safe, I will supply the whole soundbar from my power supply, which is able to provide 19 volt and also a current limitation. And I will set the current limit to 1 amp. Because I don't need all the power, and let's check if it will work. So this is the moment of truth. Yeah? I set it up my power supply to 19 volt and around 1 to 2 amps current limit. And here's the input. I see no short. And also the LED is lighting up. Let's turn it on. The Bluetooth is connected, and now
it was Pro 4 Medio PTK 640. I got also this one with this wireless kit, but without the USB receiver.
It's working. So, next step is to buy a replacement for the MOSFET, soldering it in, patch the connections, screw it together, and then it's repaired. So now please have a look on my ugly but very effective fix of the high side switch. Because the old footprint where the SO8 P-channel MOSFET was is so destroyed, I decided to fix that problem with a slightly bigger package and lower RDS on. To really guarantee that there is no much heat produced, and this will last much longer than before. I simply attached the P-channel MOSFET on a suitable footprint and glued it with super glue on the mainboard and soldered the drain to the supply of the amplifiers, the source to the input voltage, and the yellow wire is the gate which goes to the voltage divider of the small signal transistor. Now I will assembly it, and together we will see the result of the repair when the soundbar is completely assembled again. But before I will assemble it, I want to show you how to check the circuit. So the soundbar is in standby mode, you see it by the orange light. We have 19 volt on the input and around 2.4, 2.5 on the supply line of the amplifier. So the 2 volts appearing because of internal biasing from other power supplies, but this is not the power supply. So now let's turn it on, and before, the gate source voltage is 0. If we turn it on and we see clearly the MOSFET is switching through and the amplifier gets the input voltage. On the gate source we see 15.6 volt. I guess you heard this. This soundbar is fixed, and that's why it is a big bargain for my brother-in-law. Again, a small component was the problem why this good and expensive soundbar would have ended up in the trash. And that's why I love to fix that trash. Nevertheless, thanks for watching, subscribe my channel, give me a thumbs up, and I will see you next time. Bye!